बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस जेस्टेशनल ट्रोफोब्लास्टिक डिजीजेस दैट आर रिलेटेड टू द प्रोलिफरेशन ऑफ द ट्रोफोब्लास्टिक टिश्यू एंड व्हाई इट्स इम्पॉर्टेंट। इट्स इम्पॉर्टेंट बिकॉज द ट्रोफोब्लास्टिक डिजीजेस दे हैव द मेलिग्नेंट पोटेंशियल। So it's important to monitor the human chorionic gonadotropin level so that if it is much raised, we should exclude the risk of getting choriocarcinoma or we should exclude the presence of choriocarcinoma. So what are edematous gestational trophoblastic diseases? Swelling, edematous sac-like swelling of the chorionic villi. So we divide the hydatidiform mole in complete and partial mole. Complete mole is a type of mole in which we find that a single sperm, either single or double, the single sperm, it fertilizes an empty ovum. When there is fertilization of empty ovum with the 23x single sperm, it leads to homozygous complete mole in which there is chromosomal duplication. Another type is in which two sperms, they fertilize a single empty ovum, so we call this stage as dispermy, and they result in heterozygous complete mole, that is with 46xs and 46xy with the duplication. And another type is partial mole or incomplete mole. So the incomplete mole is a type of mole in which two sperms with 23x or 23y, these sperms fertilize a single ovum that has itself the chromosome number 23x, and ultimately the result is triploid partial with 69 triple X, 69 double XY or 69 XYY, rare cases. So these are the types of hydatidiform mole. How do we get them histologically? It will be discussed just now. The hydatidiform mole, it's a precursor of choriocarcinoma. It is usually detected in 4th to 5th month of pregnancy when there is much raised level of human chorionic gonadotropin level, and the age is either in teenage or between 40 to 50 years of age. Here you are given the types, complete and partial mole. Now, the difference histologically, cytogenetically, and via the flow cytometric studies, how do we differentiate between the complete and the partial mole? So karyotypically, the complete mole, it has 46XS or 46XY chromosome number. Whereas in case of partial mole, as we discussed, there is triploid type, 69XXY commonly. Regarding the villous edema, in case of complete mole, all of the chorionic villi, they will be involved and they will show villous edema. Whereas in case of partial mole, some of the villi show edema, whereas other will be normal. Then is the difference among these two based on trophoblastic proliferation. You will find diffuse circumferential trophoblastic proliferation in case of complete mole, whereas in case of partial mole, there will be only focal or slight trophoblastic proliferation seen. Then, in case of complete mole, much ATPia is seen in the cells that are trophoblastic cells, whereas in case of partial mole, you will not find ATPia. And regarding serum HCG level, that is human chorionic gonadotropin level, in case of complete mole it will be much elevated, 3 times, whereas in case of partial mole there is elevation of human chorionic gonadotropin level. 2% 60% of the complete moles, they transform into choriocarcinoma, whereas in case of partial mole, there is much rare cases which can lesion into choriocarcinoma. And you will find no fetal parts in case of complete mole, whereas commonly fetal parts are seen in case of the partial mole. Here we will discuss the morphology. Grossly, the uterus, it shows friable mass, or you may find thin walled translucent cystic grape like structures, and the villi, the that will be seen grossly, they will show vascularity in case of partial mole, whereas if these are complete mole, then you will find avascular villi. Clinical courses, the patient will have the symptoms, will have the problem of abnormal uterine bleeding, watery fluid passage, and they may show the presence of grape-like structures. And on ultrasound, these grape-like structures, these are well identified. Along with that, the labs will show human the chorionic gonadotropin level much raised in case of complete mole and slightly raised in case of partial mole. So what do the gynecologist do? She does the curettage of such patient, or evacuation and curettage is done, and the sample, these are sample is sent to the histopathologist for confirmation, and sometimes they have to perform the hysterectomy in other if there are some other complications also. So 80-90% of these molar pregnancies, these are benign. 10% they show invasion, so we call these type of moles as invasive moles, and 2.5% they transform into choriocarcinoma. And which type of mole transform into choriocarcinoma? Yes, complete mole. Because in case of partial mole, there is very less chance of getting into the choriocarcinoma. Here, my dear students, you are shown the placenta. This is the normal histological picture of the villi. These are the villi, and you can well identify that each and every villus is well vascular. See, vascular villi, they have provided with the vessels. See, these all red rounded structures, these are vessels that are seen in all of the normal villi. So this is the picture of normal chorionic villi shown to you. Now we come to the case of hydatidiform mole. Grossly, you will see these grape-like edematous structures that are found in the villi. With naked eye, you can well identify these grape-like structures in the villi that are basically edematous avascular villi. Here, more obvious picture shown to you. These grape-like bunches of grape are seen. These are basically thin-walled edematous avascular villi. Another picture. These are all edematous villi. And which type of villi? Which type of molar pregnancy is it? Is it complete mole or partial mole? Yes, it is complete mole, because the villi, these are avascular, but it will be definitely diagnosed on the microscope, under the microscope. So the microscopic examination will confirm that whether this type of mole is complete mole or partial. Here, now, these are the edematous villi. You can see these ball-like picture that are edematous villi, एंड दीज एडिमेटस विलाए दे आर ए वास्कुलर, नो वेसल इज प्रोवाइडेड टू दीज विलाए. सो दिस इज कंप्लीट मोल. एंड यू कैन ऑल्सो सी द सर्कमफ्रेंशियल प्रोलिफ्रेशन ऑफ ट्रोफोब्लास्टिक टिश्यू हेयर. More obvious picture is shown to you here. This is the proliferation of the trophoblastic cells and they show frequent atypia in case of complete mold. See, frequent atypia in the trophoblastic cells that are proliferating and they are surrounding that adimatous avascular villi that are circumferentially, these are circumferentially enclosed by these trophoblastic cells. So this is all about complete
that
mold.
You will not find fetal parts in case of complete mold.
Now we come to the partial mold. Yes, you may find some of the adimatous villi, along with that normal villi will be also seen and there will be frequent vascularity. Another picture of partial mole. Few of the villi, they show edematous grape-like picture, while others, these are of normal sizes. Here, you can see some of the villi that are edematous and they show villus edema, but the others are normal. These are normal villi and these are vascular. See vessels present, see the presence of vessels. These are vascular. So surrounding that edematous villi, you can well appreciate normal sized vascular villi. Here these are normal sized, normal looking villi. These normal villi are absent in case of complete mold. And one other thing is trophoblastic proliferation that I showed you in the slide of complete mold. Here no trophoblastic proliferation is appreciated anywhere. All these are the normal looking villi that are surrounding edematous villi. So you can here see the vascularity. So this is a picture of partial mold. This is another picture showing to you of an avascular villi. Now we come to invasive mold. When we call a mold as an invasive mold, when the molar structures that are the chorionic villi, the edematous chorionic villi, when they penetrate the uterine wall, we say that now the mole has been converted to invasive mole. And what is the importance of invasive mole? Because the invasive mole is locally destructive and it may lead to embolization in the lungs and brain. The presenting complaint is vaginal bleeding with raised human chorionic gonadotropin level. And in such cases, when we find a case of invasive mole, chemotherapy is given to that patient and it may lead to rupture of uterus. So it's important to diagnose the invasiveness of the hydatidiform mole. Now we come to choriocarcinoma, that is the malignant transformation and that is the malignant that is the cancer or malignant neoplasm that arises from the trophoblastic cells. So what is choriocarcinoma? Choriocarcinoma is a malignant neoplasm that arises from the trophoblastic cells. So it arises in the uterus. It may show some ectopic place where the pregnancy occurs and it is always and always invasive. It has rapidly metastasizing nature and it needs chemotherapy. So what is the incidence? 50% of cases, these arise from hydatidiform mole. 25% of cases, they have the history of previous abortions. 22% of cases, they have the history of normal pregnancies. And 3% are the miscellaneous.
Now we come to the morphology of choriocarcinoma. Grossly, how does it look? It looks soft, fleshy, yellow-white, necrotic and hemorrhagic material. And on the histological examination, what do we find? We find abundant anaplastic or highly bizarre atypical trophoblastic cells. What are trophoblastic cells? You all know the trophoblastic cells are the cytotrophoblastic cells and syncytiotrophoblastic cells. So these cells, they proliferate and there is abundant mitotic, atypical mitotic activity. There is much higher type of atypia in these cells. And one very important diagnostic feature is that you will not find any chorionic villi in case of choriocarcinoma, because you also find anaplastic or atypical trophoblastic cells even in the complete mole. But why do we call it as complete mole? Because along with that atypical trophoblastic cells, you also find abundant edematous chorionic villi. But when you find only and only atypical proliferation of trophoblastic cells and you find no chorionic villi at all, there are areas of abundant necrosis and hemorrhage along with trophoblastic proliferation and much more marked atypia, you will label such case as choriocarcinoma. So it's a very important feature that in case of choriocarcinoma, you will not find any chorionic villi. And definitely it will show invasion of myometrium and it will be invaded to blood vessels and lymphatics, and frequent areas of hemorrhage, necrosis and inflammatory cells will be seen along with that. So the clinical course is, it's a small tumor, it will result in the irregular spotting or brown fluid pass. On x-ray chest, you may find the metastasis, you may find bone metastasis in this case, and much marked level of human chorionic gonadotropin. And in case of hydriform mole, there may be history of previous hydriform mole. This is a good picture in which you can see markedly atypical syncytiotrophoblastic and cytotrophoblastic cells with no chorionic villi. And here you can see the areas of hemorrhage and necrosis. So abundant and frequent areas of hemorrhage necrosis, along with that you will find the marked proliferation of syncytio and cytotrophoblastic cells and no chorionic villi.